John Thomas, senior, number 11, power forward.
I'm Taylor Medina, I'm a senior, number 12, and a forward.
Noah Dahlquist, senior, number 54, center.
Wilson Lee, number 20, junior guard.
I'm Alec Holland, number 3, and I'm a junior guard.
I'm Brett Abbott, I'm number 4, a junior guard.
I'm Tristan Foster, I'm number 24, and I'm a junior guard.
I'm Jordan Reinholt, I'm a freshman and a guard.
I'm Liam Leininger, number 5, and I'm a freshman and I'm a guard.
First for the North Miami Warriors, they have a record of 0-4. At one guard will be a 5'10 senior, Evan Sumner. At the second guard, a 5'6 sophomore, Jeff Ekro. At the third guard will be a 5'10 senior, Jacob Stiver. At one forward, 6'5 senior, Dakota Ribble. And at the other forward, 6'4 senior, Cletus Yoder. Rochester, or make that North Miami coach with Mr. Clay Bolger. For the Rochester Zebras, they have a record of 1-2. At one guard will be a 5'9 junior, Alec Holland. The other guard, 6' junior, Brett Abbott. At one forward, 6'2 senior, Taylor Medina. The other forward, 6'3 senior, Dom Thomas. And in the middle tonight for the Zebras will be 6'6 senior, Noah Dahlquist, Rochester coach from Mr. Rex Reinholt. We'd also like to welcome Shepherd Chevrolet, a proud supporter of Zebra basketball, onto the broadcast tonight. We appreciate their support. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Like we said, coming into this broadcast phase, it's been a long time. Could we see some rust to start this?
Maybe. But two teams really desperate for a win.
Yeah.
Both teams struggling. You're here at the conference. We said when we started, everybody's playing in the conference tonight. At the end of the night, there'll be four teams at 1-0 and four at 0-1, and you'd like to be one in the lead group.
Yeah.
And, you know, for the Zebras coming off of a tough loss in all aspects against Winnemac, I think a good start's important, and I think a consistent performance is second of importance.
Yeah. Well, I think you're going to see, I'm hoping to see, a lot better effort keeping North Miami off the offensive glass.
Yeah, better effort on the boards, better ball movement, staying within the system, energy. You know, those things are always key here as you head towards the holidays.
Noah Dahlquist wins the tip. The Zebras will start with the basketball going to our left. Rochester in their home white and North Miami in their road red. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Varsity contest here at Rochester High School. The Zebras have it. Swing it to the right side of Medina to Dom in the lane. His turnaround jumper in the paint, no good, and we're going to have a foul immediately on Noah Dahlquist.
Stop me if you've heard this before.
Yeah.
An early foul for a Rochester post player. 17 seconds in the game. Good ball movement by Zebras. North Miami's extending that zone, and those flash cuts across the paint are going to be open. That's a good shot for Dom.
Rochester to full court press. Ekrod across the timeline right. Rose to the wing. Now goes to the basket. His layup is blocked from behind by Holland. And it'll go out of bounds, and North Miami will keep it baseline right.
Good pressure, but you know, like to see somebody slide over to the sideline,
right.
Cut that off. You don't want to allow a guy to go in almost uncontested, 84 feet for a layup.
I was going to say, coast to coast, you're right. Sumner looks to get it in. Bounce pass is tipped away and stolen by Abbott. Abbott picks up his dribble, now to Thomas. Dom crosses the timeline right for Rochester. Now to Medina, swings left side to Abbott. Abbott holds the ball above his head. High on the right side to Holland. Download it. Thomas outside to Holland. Alec passes up a three, gives to Medina in the corner to Abbott. Brett Abbott, couple of dribbles inside the paint. His jumper in the lane is good, and Rochester up 2-0 with 50 seconds gone in the first quarter. Then Abbott knocks the basketball out of bounds, and it'll be North Miami basketball right in front of their Rochester bench.
Two deflections already for Abbott, too. Good effort on defensive end and a nice drive and jump stop in the paint to, again, get inside that zone. Don't rely on three-point shots. Get inside that zone as much as possible, play inside out.
Well, the last time we were here, Abbott did a great job of getting inside that 2-3 zone and rising up in the lane. North Miami in the lane, outside to Stiver. He travels, going to the elbow, and Rochester going to get it back. 2-0 here at Rochester High School early in this basketball game.
North Miami going to dial up some pressure of their own here. Looks like kind of a 1-2-2.
Press.
Yep, Deaver's going to try to flash somebody middle. And
Thomas has it, left side, jump pass to Medina, spins away from traffic, outside of Holland for three, right corner is good. Rochester up 5-0, 6:40, Coach Bowles are going to his bench already. Stiver brings up the floor quickly, in the paint, jump pass in the corner to Sumner, now to Ribble on the right elbow, above his head to Ekro, left side to Yoder, quick three off the window, no good, And the rebound to Dahlquist, who gives to Holland. Alex pushes up the floor for Rochester. Right side to Medina. Medina holds behind the high three-point line. No look pass down low to Dahlquist. His jumper in the paint is good. And Rochester up 7-0.
Good soft touch.
And a lot of contact.
Yeah, another good stat is three Zebras have already scored. Three buckets by three different Zebras. That's another good sign.
Diver gets away with the travel. Then maybe a little hip flex by Medina forced another travel. And Rochester going to get it back. Huffman comes in for the first time. Also, the leading three-point shooter for North Miami, Trevor Lynn, comes in for the first time for North Miami. 6 minutes to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 7-0. The Zebras at the basketball is going to our left. Thomas bounce pass top of the key to Holland. Now to Medina, swings left side to Abbott. Abbott has his pass kicked away by Lynn, and Rochester will keep possession baseline left as Jordan Reinhold comes in for the game for the first time tonight. And coming out is Brett Abbott.
Good job by, you know, Dom's just flashing in the middle of the zone. Spread the court a little bit, get to that middle of the 2-3 zone, and you can either pass to the opposite or take that pull-up jumper yourself.
Dahlquist runs the baseline, cut off by the double team. Got to get rid of it, and he's going to travel. A little bit more enthusiasm a minute and a half, 2 minutes in than what we've seen.
Yeah, energy's picked up. Of course, when you're knocking down shots, it's always easy to feel good, but the defensive energy has been there from the start. Rebounding
right,
has been good, and ball movement's good.
A little man-to-man press. Driver gets away from Medina, gives the Ribble. Ribble at the volleyball line right between the ring. Drives against Dahlquist, and Noah Dahlquist just picked up foul number two.
Well, his second, team second.
So it'll be out of bounds to North Miami, the far side of the timeline.
Wilson Lee going to check in for Noah Dahlquist. But if the Zebras do want to get up and down the floor, you know, that allows them to do a little bit better with Wilson
right
than Noah.
And now somebody's got to handle Ribble. And he gets it on the block against Lee. On the spin move, has the ball tipped around. Noah makes that. Dom Thomas comes out of it with it. He pushes. Gets it ahead to Holland. His 15-footer right baseline is good. 9-0, Rochester. Then Medina tips the basketball out of bounds on the full-court press. It will stay with North Miami.
Another deflection. That's great. I mean, you don't get turnovers, but that's just, it shows the offense you're active. It just sets your defense back up, and it's just frustrating for the offense to have to keep taking the ball out of bounds.
Huffman will work to get it in around Thomas. Does so to Stiver. Stiver against Medina. Stiver, middle of the floor, at the volleyball line at Rochester's end. Crosses the timeline right, runs around Dom Thomas, gives him the corner to Sumner. He'll fire a three from the baseline. It's no good. And Ribble comes over the back of Alec Holland, and North Miami going to pick up the foul, and Rochester going to get it back.
Nice job. Again, you get rewarded when you block out.
Absolutely.
But Jordan did. You know, you can put a butt in the gut, and you're going to draw that foul. Nice job by Jordan.
Brett Abbott comes back into the game, and checking out is Taylor Medina. Eckroat comes back in for North Miami, and Sumner will sit down. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. 5:04 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 9-0. North Miami to full court press. Holland to Thomas to Reinhold. Crosses the timeline right in the corner to Abbott. Abbott runs. Pull up from 12 feet. It's in and out. No good. And the rebound is taken by Lynn. Trevor Lynn pushes for North Miami. Rochester up by 9. Lynn, 3, top of the key. Nope, no good. Holland with the rebound. Has it knocked out of his hands by Ribble. Oh, they're going to say last touch by Alec Holland.
Okay.
And Holland thinks it's off of North Miami. And now Ribble will trigger it in right in front of the Rochester bench. 4:43 to play in the first quarter. Zebras up 9-0. Ribble got to get it in. And then bangs it off the leg of Wilson Lee and out of bounds. It'll stay with North Miami as Taylor Medina comes back in for Rochester. And coming out will be Dominic Thomas.
You know, fresh rotation, keeping guys in, moving guys out. You know, Noah may have to sit a little bit with longer than everybody else with two fouls, but, you know, those other guys, as Brett Abbott gets his third deflection here already.
And force another turnover.
Yep.
So North Miami will stay in a full court press. Zebras up 9 at 9-0 with 4:41 to play. In the first quarter, Reinhold looks to get it in. Just over the top of the defense to Wilson Lee, who bounce passes to Holland. Alec Holland across the timeline right. Against the double team over the top to Abbott. And we're going to have a foul. Is that going to be on Ribble?
I think so. I think kind of a jump pass by Alec. And Ribble went through his arm and tried to deflect the pass and got his arm instead.
I'll tell you what, Dakota Ribble is a good-looking athlete.
Yeah, but the Zebras like the view of him sitting on the bench right now with two fouls. That's the best view for them right now.
Sumner comes back into the game. He replaces Ribble with two fouls. Wilson Lee high on the left side. Bounce pass to Medina. Over the top of the defense to Abbott on the left wing. Abbott now middle of the floor. Works to the right wing. Hands off to Holland. Alec in the corner to Reinhold. Jordan travels.
one of those cases, I think you made a little maybe freshman mistake trying to make the move before you get the pass.
Yeah. Rochester will be in a full-court press. Sumner gets the pass from Huffman, who gives to Stiver. Stiver against Reinhold across the timeline. Pushes ahead to Ekro to wrap around pass to Huffman. His layup is good. 9-2. Rochester with 4:08 to play in the first quarter. Wilson Lee high on the right side. One dribble to Alex Holland left wing to Medina. Medina to the baseline. Goes to the wing to Lee. Right side to Reinhold for three. Good. Jordan Reinhold buries the three from the right corner. And the Zebras up by 10. Stiver around the defense. Goes to the basket. He's going to be fouled on the shot. And it's going to send Stiver to the line to shoot two.
Holland looked like he was there just almost in time. Not in the minds of the referee, but really close. He might have been leaning just a little bit, but that was a good effort by Alex. Again, I've said this before, you're not going to get a charge unless you're thinking about it. You can't react and get a charge. And Alex was hunting that charge. He was thinking about it before he tried. He's just half step slow.
Stiver bangs the first one in. He'll have one more. Jacob Stiver, to this point, in my opinion, the best ball handler for North Miami.
Yeah, the Zebras have had a hard time keeping in front of him. He's broken that press pretty much by himself.
Yeah. Second one for Stiver, good in. 12-4, Rochester, full court press by the Warriors. Oh, Reinhold gets away with a lazy pass, and Medina gets the pass across the timeline. And his pass is deflected out of bounds, and Rochester will keep possession baseline right with 3:41 to play in the first quarter, up by 8. Medina will look to trigger it in underneath his own basket. Taylor slaps the basketball, sends things in motion. Bounce pass into Reinhold. Over the top to Wilson Lee. Lee holds. One dribble in the corner to Medina. Taylor dribbles to the elbow. Jump pass over the defense to Abbott. Abbott in his side. Has the ball taken away. It's loose from the floor. Stiver comes out of there with it. Gives to Huffman. Now Sumner. Sumner ahead to Lynn. Lynn in the paint. Fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
That last possession there. Brett's got to get rid of that one dribble quick. He got too far deep inside. Holland was open on the wing. That's got to be an easy kick to Alec for an open three. He kept held the ball too long, didn't get that pass, and turned it over.
And I think that's what Coach Reinhold was yelling as well. I think I started with Wilson Lee. Got to get rid of it. First one by Trevor Lynn is no good. We'll have one more. And Liam Leininger and also Tristan Foster will come in now for Rochester.
I was going to say, at the pace that this game is, with both teams trying to press and trap and do those kinds of things, good rotations in terms of subbing guys in and out is going to be key. That's where it hurts to have Noah with two fouls, but I think both teams are going to have to really use their bench tonight.
Here's what I like. Alec Holland came out. Who's going to score now?
We'll find out.
Yep, you're right. Somebody's got to step up and score.
Yep.
Lynn hits one of two. It's 12-5. Rochester. Reinhold across the timeline from Abbott. Back to Abbott. To Wilson Lee, to Reinhold. Three, right wing for the Zebras. Good again! Found one.
Yeah, that's a good sign.
Rochester up by 10, 15-5. Stiver coast to coast, found him a shot. He'll go back on the line to shoot two.
Thanks. Maybe found a score, but you got to find a solution for Stiver on that press.
Yeah.
It's not as effective if you let one guy beat it by himself. You got to have to either get a better rotation or maybe change the type of press you want to use, because you got to keep that young man in front of you because he continues to draw fouls.
So Stiver has two for the Warriors. First one is good. Thomas back into the game, and checking out will be Wilson Lee with two fouls now.
Yeah, Wilson Lee has two fouls. Noah Dolphus has two fouls. Alec Holland has one for the Zebras.
So Stiver with one more for the Warriors. Stiver, second one. Good again. 15-7. Rochester on top. Warriors in a full court press. Jordan Reinhold with the basketball. And Reinhold will walk it up against Ekroat. Gives the head to Liam Leininger. Leininger in the corner to Foster. Tristan to Dom. Elbow shot off the glass. No good. And the rebound to Abbott. Brett in the paint. Rises up. Shot on the way is no good again. And the rebound fall for Sumner for North Miami comes out of there. Now leads the head to Lynn. Lynn against Thomas. Jumper on the way. No good. Foster with the rebound. And then Tristan Foster throws it out of bounds, and North Miami will get it back.
I think that's one. That was a play. I think Dom could have had a charge there. He just didn't fall. I think he got to complete the act. I mean, he was in good position. He kept his hands up high, and he just didn't complete the act. I think if he falls, I think he gets a charge call.
So North Miami gets the basketball back after the Rochester turnover. It's 2:35 to play in the first quarter. The Zebras by 8. As Lynn high on the left side for North Miami to Sumner. Sumner drives it left at the elbow, jumps off to Huffman down low to Lynn. Lynn on the left baseline, dribbles back out to the wing. Now middle of the floor and resets to North Miami, gives to Stiver. Stiver goes to the wing against Reinhold. Back to Lynn, quickly to Ekrode. Ekrode, lob pass to Huffman. Huffman against Thomas, loses the handle and his footing, and the ball taken away by Holland. I didn't even see him come back into the game.
No.
And then Holland passes.
Quick and often. It's like hockey. You just get a coming down on your end.
Don't need that to stop play. 2:11 to play, first quarter. Rochester by 8 at 15-7. Reinholt runs the point. He'll work against Sumner in the man-to-man defense. Reinholt works high on the right side. Bounce pass to Holland. Alex drives it to the elbow. Jump pass to Foster. Foster on the wing and travels. Rochester will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. .58 to play in the first quarter. Rochester leads 15-7. And after the Rochester timeout, they'll have the basketball. No, they won't have. North Miami will have it after the turnover.
Right. Turnover on Foster there before the timeout. Timeout, Coach Reinholz just talking about better get ball reversal. They haven't moved the ball as well these last couple minutes than they did at the start of the game, and they're not getting the type of shots that they got as a result of that ball movement the first 4 minutes.
So North Miami has it going to our right. Diver runs the point, crosses the timeline left, accelerates around the defense in the corner to Sumner. His three is in and out. Huffman has the rebound. The putback is good and a foul.
Zebra's paid for not getting by Huffman, although that's not an easy task. That man's a load inside, and you're going to have to get maybe two bodies to keep him off the board. Dom's picking up his first, team six.
Kevin Huffman, a 6'1 senior at the line to shoot one free throw. Looking to cut the lead to 5, and he does not. It's ball's in and out. Nice soft touch, though, by the big man. Thomas with the rebound to Holland. Holland almost has his pocket pick. Gets the basketball back. Now to Reinholt. Drives the baseline. Cut off by the double team. Ball loose from the floor. Still loose from the floor. Huffman comes out of there with it, and Jordan Reinholt's not going to win that war. It's a tough foul to pick up, though, because they were both going for the loose basketball, and they're going to call Reinholt with a foul and reach in.
And they're going to shoot free throws the rest of the half. Jordan was okay. When the scrum started, Jordan's hand was right on the ball, but Huffman kind of a veteran senior move as he turned away with the ball, and that made Jordan's hand look like he was coming down on
the
wrist.
True. So Huffman at the back of the line, this time 1-1. First one away is good. He'll have one more. 15-10, Rochester. Brett Abbott back into the game, and Leininger will come out.
North Miami's already shot 8 free throws, and they're going to shoot for the rest of the half.
Yeah, the rest of the half. We're a minute 33 to play in the first quarter.
Right.
Huffman, second one is good again. 15-11. Rochester's lead has been cut to 4. With a minute 30 to play in the first quarter. Abbott against Lynn. Drives around the defense at the elbow. Kicks it in the corner to Holland. 3 on the way. Is in and out. No good. And Thomas has a rebound, and his outlet pass is taken away by North Miami. Now to Stiver. Stiver, right side of the floor, goes to the basket, shot on the way, it's no good. We're going to have a foul, and Stiver on the charge.
That was a nice job by Brett. Getting front, taking that charge. Legal guarding position. You know, Brett did a good job, saw that coming down. You knew Stiver was going to the basket. He's done that every time down the floor. Way to learn from previous mistakes and get in position to take a good charge.
Dahlquist back into the game. Thomas to sit. Jordan Reinholt will be picked up at the timeline by Sumner and for the North Miami Warriors. Reinholt left side of the floor behind the three-point line and throws it out of bounds. Nobody even close except for a cheerleader. I think, Foster looking back door, and Jordan thought he was going to cut to the corner.
A zig versus a zag.
A minute 3 to play, first quarter, Rochester by 4. Ekrode splits the double team, has the ball tipped away, ball loose. North Miami and Sumner picks it up on Rochester's side of the timeline. Now to Stiver. Stiver drives through the double team, kicks it out to Sumner. His shot is on the way short, and the rebound to Abbott. Boy, Stiver could have picked up another charge. And then Abbott loses the handle, picked up by Stiver. Stiver left side of the floor, and his ball taken away. He gets it back. His shot blocked from behind. Sumner right there in the paint to get it. He pulls it out to reset. Eckroat to Lynn. Lynn back to Eckroat with 30 seconds to play in the first quarter. Rochester by four. Eckroat backs it out to the 10-second line. Drives it left for North Miami inside the three-point line for the Warriors. Looks back door to Stiver. Has it tipped away and stolen by Holland. Holland middle of the floor. Gives the head to Foster. His leaner off the glass is good.
Great lead pass by Alec Holland. He put that one exactly where it needed to be and used the bounce pass.
Stiver around the defense with eight. Throws up a tough shot. No good with six. Dahlquist with the rebound with four. Holland runs with three. Holland with two. Holland at the volleyball line at the buzzer. It's no good. After one, Rochester leads by six. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
First Federal Savings Bank is Rochester's only locally owned bank. Stop in today to start a new checking or savings account. Learn more about our online banking options or sign up for Go Green Checking, the checking account that pays you back every time you use your card. Stop in today to see why local banking is better banking. First Federal Savings Bank, serving Rochester and surrounding communities since 1966.
Meet Bob and Stan. Both bought new TVs. Stan watches all the popular ringside live events, boxing, wrestling, and the big fight. Bob can't. Stan gets out-of-market sports packages of baseball, hockey, and basketball. Bob can't. Stan gets live concerts and the hottest Hollywood hits. What's the difference? Stan uses InDemand's pay-per-view for all the special events, sports programs, and the newest movie releases. So call RTC today and start your own pay-per-view experience.
Going to the second quarter here at Rochester High School, the Zebras leading 17-11, and starting the second period, North Miami had the basketball going to our right. Rochester showed glimpses of really putting this away early, and North Miami climbed back into it.
Yeah, they had like three different spurts, two good and one bad. First 4 minutes really good, then they had about a two-minute lull, then the last 2 minutes were pretty good. Got to get a little more consistency.
And Stivers too quick for Taylor Medina to guard way out there, and he's going to get the hand check foul, which is going to send Stiver back to the line to shoot free throws for the Warriors.
Medina's first team ace. Zebra's going to get into foul trouble. We already mentioned North Miami shooting free throws this entire half. Got to do something for Stiver because he's shown himself to just go to the basket and draw fouls. Going to have to find an answer to that.
Stiver's first free throw is good. He'll have one more.
And because he's a good free throw shooter, 5 for 5.
Coming up at halftime, Rochester Wrestling Coach Clint Gard will be joining us. We'll talk about the North Miami win last Thursday and, of course, the Logan Sport tourney win as well. Stiver hits both, cuts the lead to four. Rochester with it, going to our left. Medina in the corner to Foster. Bounce pass on the wing to Wilson Lee, and unfortunately, Wilson Lee stepped into the passing lane, or Sumner would have picked that off for North Miami. It'll be a foul on the Warriors. And Rochester basketball to bounce baseline, right at the scorer's table.
Sumner's first, team's fourth.
Yoder back in, and Stiver comes out for North Miami. Abbott bounce pass into Holland, and Alec will cross the timeline right through the center circle to Medina high on the right side. One dribble. Back to Holland, left side to Abbott. Abbott in the corner to Foster. Foster left wing to Holland. Quickly to Medina. Medina drives it right. Jump stop, and he's going to be fouled by Huffman. And that'll be the team fifth on the Warriors.
Yeah, whereas Huffman's a tough load inside. If you can get him, if they're going to play
right
man, get him pull out, that's an advantage Medina all day long.
Rochester will use another 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Six
to play in the first half. Rochester leading 17-13 here at Rochester High School. After the Zebra timeout, they'll have it with Medina. Now Holland in the left corner, in the right corner, high on the right side to Abbott. Stands with the ball above his head to Foster. Left side now to Wilson. Wilson looks in the corner to Holland. dribbles to the wing. Right wing pass down to Medina. Drives the paint hard. Goes up for the shot. It's good off the glass.
If they're going to play man and Hep off on Medina, that's all day right there.
Lynn, quick three right wing for the Warriors is air ball. Medina comes flying in for the board. Grabs and gives to Foster. Foster across the timeline against Yoder. Now to Medina. Medina drives again and kicks it into the lane to Holland. Holland for three is good. Holland from the corner pushes the lead back to 9 at 22-13.
Good adjustment by the Zebras. Medina's going to be able to drive on Huffman. If they send help, there's going to be wide open shooters.
Yoder, top to Huffman, left side to Lynn, baseline to Sumner. Sumner fakes a shot, drives, jumper over the defense is no good. Yoder there to grab it and put it in for two. That's an easy two.
Wow, this guy's right in front of him. You're not going to get an easier look than that.
Holland for three, no. And the rebound to Huffman. Huffman one dribble, now to Ekros. I'm not sure that Coach Reinhold liked that shot selection. Ekros around the defense, in the paint. On the baseline to Yoder, his shot blocked from behind, and we're going to have a foul now on Taylor Medina. That's a late call, and that's going to send Cletus Yoder to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, I don't.
So at the line is 6'4 senior Cletus Yoder for North Miami with 6:11 to play in the first half. Yoder's free throw is short, he'll have one more. Lining her back in for Rochester. And Stiver coming back in for the Warriors. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. 6:11 to play, first half. Rochester up 22-15. Yoder's second one for the Warriors, short again, and the rebound to Abbott. Fred against Lynn, across the timeline, inside the three-point line, left side, back door to Medina. Layup is good!
Good pass by Brett, good position. Way to get position by Medina.
Stiver quickly up the floor against Taylor Medina. This is Lynn, down low to Yoder, wide open layup is good. 7-point lead for the Zebras with 5:45 to play in the first half. Leininger to Holland, right side to Abbott, in the corner to Medina. Medina out to Holland, high on the right side, now left wing to Leininger. Leininger drives it right, jump stop, outside to Medina in the corner. Taylor to a cutting Wilson Lee at the elbow, right. Now back to Holland, and Rochester resets to the volleyball line, in the corner to Leininger. Leininger, a couple of dribbles to the wing. Baseline to Holland. To Medina on the right side. Left wing pass to Holland. To make that to Abbott. Abbott, jump stop, rises up. He's fouled from behind. He'll go to the line to shoot two. 5:14 to play in the first half. Rochester back at the free throw line to shoot two, leading by seven. Reinhold and Thomas will come back in after the first free throw for Rochester. Huffman for the Warriors to come back in.
Zebras will now also be shooting free throws the rest of the half. Good sign. This is their first free throw attempt of the night.
Abbott Brady is no good.
In the meantime, North Miami's attempted 13 free throws.
Wow. So Wilson Lee to come out. Tristan Foster came out. Ribble back in for the Warriors and Huffman back in as well.
I can see Brett knock some of these free throws down.
Yeah.
He kind of struggled there this year. He's shown a nice job getting to the free throw line, but if you're going to play that game where you're going to drive and draw fouls, I'd like to see him make a few more of these.
Abbott with one more for the Zebras. Misses both of them. Huffman to the board. 24-17 Rochester. North Miami runs. Stiver in the paint. Runs over Reinhold. A lot of contact, no call. Throws up a shot. Holland with the rebound and runs. Holland. Left side of Reinhold. Jordan in the paint at the free throw line. Kicks it out to Leininger. Leininger drives in the paint. Goes to the basket hard. Jump passes right off the hands of Reinhold out of bounds. And I think that Coach, yeah, that's exactly what Coach Reinhold said. Just shoot that thing. You're 5 foot away.
Yeah, it was a good look. He's trying to make an extra pass, set up his fellow freshman teammate Jordan up, who was underneath the basket. But I think Jordan's going for the rebound. I don't think he was ready for the pass either.
And that pass was a bullet.
Yeah. Might want to use a changeup next time. That fastball had some heat.
So, Taylor Medina's got some blood on his jersey and his shorts. 4:42 to play in the first half. Somebody's got blood. And
someone are going to have to clean that off. Yep, Christina Hughes is there with the solution to get that off the uniforms.
So, Dahlquist will come into the game for Rochester, and Medina will come out. I'm not sure if they found the blood source.
Yeah.
4:52 to play first half, Rochester by seven. Holland has it on his jersey as well.
That's nice, the medical advancements in having a spray to get that blood, because, you know, back in the day, you'd have to completely change the uniform. And
yeah. Boy, Medina had it all over him. The front of him, on the back of him, on his short.
I'm not sure how there can be that much blood and not be able to find it.
Yeah, no doubt. Gee. 4:45 to play, first half. Rochester by 7. Diver against Reinholdt. Works high on the right side to Ribble. Ribble holds the basketball against Thomas. One dribble to his right. Cut off by the defense. Jump pass down low to Huffman. Taken away by Dahlquist. No, and now to Leininger. Rochester runs to our left. Now to Holland high on the right side. Holly behind his back dribble. Leininger top of the key. Swings left side to Dom. Thomas at the elbow to Dahlquist. Right corner to Holland. Fakes the shot. Drives it. Rises up. Off the glass. No good. Rebounded Ribble. And Thomas is going to come over the back. And that's going to send a Ribble to the line to shoot two for the Warriors.
And Dom Thomas joins the two-foul club. Also there is Taylor Medina, Noah Dahlquist, Wilson Lee. He was now at 10 fouls, so North Miami's in a double bonus. And Ribble will go to the line for the first time.
For the Warriors, shooting two.
You want that?
Warriors are 9 for 13 from the free throw line.
So the first one for Ribble is good. He'll have one more for the Warriors. It's been a 7-point deficit, or now 6-point deficit, for a long time.
Right. It's 10 points from the free throw line. Only hit 4 field goals.
Second one for Ribble is no good. And Leininger comes down with the board after North Miami had about 2 sets of hands on that offensive board and missed it. Leininger drives a hard right, kicks it out to Holland high on the right side. Holly middle of the floor and gets away with the carry. Woo! Now to Thomas. Dom. Right elbow to Dahlquist. Dahlquist rises up from 5 foot. It goes in off the glass.
Nice job to get himself gathered. You know, looked like he was going to be out of control, and he kind of used a jump stop. The pump fake kind of helped slow himself down and use the glass. Always like to see that, too.
Ribble. His pass is deflected right into the hands of Rochester. Jordan Reinholdt to Holland. Fakes a three and travels. 3:45 to play, first half. Rochester by 8. Medina back into the game. Foster back into the game. Thomas and Dahlquist to come out.
Try to get, kind of massage the foul situation a little bit here with both Dom and Noah having 2 and only 3:45 left in the second. Try to keep those guys from getting that third foul here in the first half. Big stretch here, 3:43. Zebras can get a strong run. You can put some distance.
And Reinholdt just picked up a foul at the top of the key, trying to guard Stiver, that is.
No, he also has 2. Stiver goes the line where he's 6 for 6.
When, if ever, do you think that we might see a zone defense? Because now we've got a foul situation.
Yeah, it's tough. I know Coach Reinholdt's doesn't like to play a lot of zone, trying to get these guys to be aggressive. But you're right, at some point, you got to give another look, keep somebody in front of you. And
Stiver hits 1 of 2 on that trip. It's 26-19. Reinholdt outside left against Lynn. Takes him to the middle of the floor. Picks up his dribble now. That left wing to Foster. Foster to Leininger in the paint. Kicks it out to Medina for 3. Left baseline is good. Rochester back by 10 with 3:20 to play in the first half. Stiver has a shot blocked. Holland tried to grab the board and go, but he went before he grabbed the board and off a shoe and out of bounds.
Medina's got 7 all this first half, or all in the second quarter, I mean.
Baseline right is Lynn. Lynn gets it into Ekro. To Sumner, now to Stiver. Stiver between the rings, drives it right into paint, kicks it out to Sumner for 3. Right baseline is off the back of the iron, no good. And Huffman just comes over the back of Medina, and that's going to send Taylor Medina to the line to shoot 1 of the bonus.
I think, you know, North Miami hasn't hit a 3 yet. They haven't hit many shots. I think, you know, if you're going to play man, just kind of do what the Zebras did there. Collapse on Stiver when he drives it.
Yeah.
Make him kick it out to somebody else and take your chances there. You know, send 2 or 3 people to Stiver, make him kick it out and take your chances there and get a block out, get an over the back call, and get to the free throw line yourself. Medina, as I said, has 7 points all in this quarter. He's got 7. Alec Holland has 8. Brett Abbott has 2. Noah Dahlquist has 4. Tristan Foster has 2. And Jordan Reinholdt has 6. So some good balance for the Zebras.
Medina 1 in the bonus for the Zebras. And he hits the first one, which pushes the Rochester lead to the biggest of the night so far of 11. 3:08 to play the first half. Don't forget Rochester Wrestling Coach Clint Gard coming up here at the break. We'll talk a little Rochester Wrestling. And the Lady Zebras in action tomorrow morning at North Miami. Second one by Medina's no good. And the rebound to Lynn. North Miami runs to our right. Lynn, outside left, cut off by Medina. Now brings it to the top of the key and sets it up to Sumner. Sumner holds against Leininger. Sumner at the volleyball line. Drives it to right side. Find the three-point line on the wing. Top to Lynn. Quickly left side to Eckroat. Eckroat drives in the paint. He throws up a shot over the defense. No good. Medina rips and runs. Medina right side of the floor for Rochester. Low look pass to Thomas. Has it taken away. Ball loose. He picks it up. And now Dom has it. Quickly to Leininger. Left side to Holland. Holly around the defense. Floater on the way off the glass is good. 32-19. Quickly, Eckroat pushes for North Miami. 2:27 to play in the first quarter. Outside to Lynn. To Sumner. Three left baseline. Good for North Miami. Lead to Rochester is back to 10. Thomas, left baseline for the Rochester Zebras. Couple of dribbles inside the three-point line. Now to Leininger. Leininger drives. Goes to the basket. Before the shot, he's going to be fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot one in the bonus. 2:08 to play in the first half. Rochester by 10. And the freshman, Liam Leininger, will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus for Rochester.
Leininger has not yet been to the line tonight.
Let's talk a little bit, when you have time, about the your holiday tournament format.
Okay.
Leininger's free throw short. Rebound to Lynn. Lynn runs for the Warriors. Loses the handle. Ball loose from the floor. Medina has it. Now to Thomas. Gives ahead to Leininger. Leininger outside left for the Zebras, up by 10, under 2 to play in the first half. Dom at the free throw at the volleyball line between the rings and Medina. Medina fakes, and his pass is kicked out of bounds by North Miami. And back in the game is Wilson Lee and Brett Abbott.
Holiday tournament, real quick. January 2nd, we play at Knox High School against South Central. Varsity will play at 6. JV will play after. Then January 3rd, the games all move to West Central. Argus and West Central, the other two teams.
Holland for three, draws nothing but air. Quickly, North Miami pushes. Diver hesitates, now accelerates in the corner to Sumner. Three on the way again, is good again! 32-25, 90 seconds to play in the first half. Medina, wide open Wilson lead, he loses it out of bounds.
That was a great look, great ball movement by the Zebras, getting that zone to shift and move. So,
first night is at Knox?
At Knox, yeah, because it's the Knox boys and Winnemac boys. Us in South Central, Knox and Winnemac are the four schools that only have one gender, and Argus and West Central have both boys and girls. That's why they always play each other, so they can play a boy-girl doubleheader. We're us. Well, it used to be KV. KV got out to host their own tournament in South Central. Really good South Central team has taken their place. So the four of us are kind of the misfit toys, and you know we get to play.
Yeah.
That. So this will be the final year of that. We're going to host a one-day shootout next year over the holidays, play two games in one day, and looking forward to that.
Do you find that's what a lot of schools are going to?
I think so.
First one by Sumner is good.
Northfield started that this year. Northfield and Southwood both played in it. Now they can set it up so they don't play each other. That's the nice thing about shootout. You can predetermine your opponent. So even if it's somebody that you play, it's not a tournament where you could end up playing them. So, that's a lot because, again, they gave us 22 games but didn't stretch out the length of the season, so you're packing two more games in. Two games in one day is a really good way to get those games in.
Yoder knocks the basketball away. He goes in and has his basketball tipped out of bounds from behind by Holland. 1:08 to play in the first half, Rochester by 5.
Big minute here. Zebras had a double-digit lead. Now it's down to 5.
Yep.
A couple buckets either way makes a huge difference here in this last minute.
Baseball pass into Lynn, over the top of the defense to Stivers. Stiver against Holland, goes to the basket, throws up a shot, it's short. Rebound tipped around, Thomas comes out of there with it to Medina. Medina runs to the left under 1 minute to play in the first half. Picks up the dribble, gives it to Thomas, left side to Abbott. Abbott drives it to the free throw line, cut off by the defense, looks back door to Medina, has the pass stolen by Eckroat, and he runs for North Miami. Eckroat to the right, Eckroat stops. His pass tipped away and stolen by Medina. Ahead to Abbott. Abbott right side of the floor against Stiver. Goes to the basket. Leaner on the way is good. Helter Skelter tenders in for Rochester with 30 seconds to play in the first half. 34-27. North Miami across the timeline. Eckert high on the right side. Now middle of the floor to Lynn. Left side to Yoder. The baseline to Stiver. Stiver looking back door to Sumner. Can't find him. Now has him on the baseline. His shot blocked, but he gets it back, and then Wilson Lee takes it away with 16. Wilson Lee gives to Holland with 12. Crosses the timeline with 10. Gives to Abbott now with 9. Brett Abbott works to the right side with 7. Bounce pass to Lee with 6. Down the corner to Holland with 4. Alex, 3 with 2. Is no good. Weak side rebound to Wilson Lee. His put back at the buzzer is no good. At halftime, Rochester leads 34-27. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
I've been buying vehicles at Shepherd Chevrolet for over 16 years. They've always had the vehicle I wanted at a price that I could afford. I trust Shepherd's sales staff to give me the best price and the best financing available. From my work trucks to my personal vehicle, Shepherd's is the only choice for me. Stop out to Shepherd Chevrolet today to get your next vehicle. They really are my local hometown Chevy dealer.
Buying your first home? Let the experts at First Federal Savings Bank help you through the process. At First Federal, all of their mortgage loans are serviced locally, with payment options that are convenient for you. Their staff will work with you, answering your questions and providing professional service. First Federal will even pay standard closing costs for qualifying first-time homebuyers. Just another way First Federal takes care of you, your local mortgage lender.
Collin has 10, Brett Abbott has 4, Taylor Medina has 8, Noah Dahlquist has 4, Tristan Foster has 2, and Jordan Reinhold has 6.
So Rochester just does come out of the locker room. I'm not sure if I've ever seen a team stay in the locker room that long. The Zebras did. They'll come out, not even shooting here between the second and third quarter here at halftime, and they'll get the ball going to our right. Rochester by 7 to start the second half, and this is where all the questions come. For the North Miami Warriors, can they complete a full game? The second half has been miserable all year for North Miami.
Well, the Zebras, you know, have played well in the second half, but they've usually been trailing. So now they have a lead going in the second half. See if they can they have their normal strong second half here these first few minutes. That's important.
Having the paint, leaner on the way, short, and the rebound knocked away. Thomas has it. He kicks it out to Medina. Taylor just inside the three-point line is good.
We have our second Zebra in double figures. Medina now has 8.
And Rochester back. The 9-point lead as Stiver gives him the corner to Sumner. His shot over the defense is short, and the rebound to Dahlquist. Noah gives to Abbott. Rochester pushes up by 9. Abbott high on the right side against Lynn. Crossover dribble takes him to the free throw line. Now in the paint, out to Holland. Quick three for the left wing. It's good as it rattles in. And now North Miami will use a timeout at the 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Smith Farms.
-11 to play in the third quarter. Rochester's lead now up to 12. Tony, got some scores?
In girls, it's 4-girl doubleheader down in Manchester. Southwood beats Manchester 39-34 in the girls' portion. Lewis Cass, boys, 35-24 in the third quarter over Taylor. That's Basil Mobby going back as head coach of Taylor at Lewis Cass. So he's coaching against them. And then in the boys' version of that doubleheader, Southwood leads Manchester 7-3 at the end of one. St. Joe girls had a tough one tonight over South and Adams, 84-35.
Yikes. A minute gone here in the third quarter. Rochester by 12. Ribble against Dahlquist. Rises up over the defense. Shot is in and out. No good. And Abbott with the rebound pushes ahead to Holland. Holland on the left side. Gives to Abbott. Middle of the floor. Right side to Thomas. Thomas fakes a shot. Drives the baseline. Leaner on the way. Blocker behind. Ball fought for. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Rochester. We'll go back to the Warriors.
You said this is danger zone for the Warriors and bad things for them. I mean, you give up 55 points right away and have to take a timeout.
Yeah.
They're looking for some quick scores, and the Zebras looking for a quick knockout punch.
Lynn has his pocket picked by Holland. Alec Holland, right-handed layup off the window is good.
Holland's now got 15. It's been at least 15 every game this year.
39-27 Rochester. Stiver, middle of the floor, in the corner to Eckroat. He fakes a shot, gives down low to Stiver. He's standing out of bounds, and he gets the pass. It's going to go back to the Zebras, and Coach Balzer now has just sit down.
Would have been a nice play. I mean, the ball movement was good for the Warriors, but you got to make sure you're in bounds
yeah.
when you catch the ball.
That'd help. 6:13 to play, third quarter. Rochester up 41-27. Alec Holland against Eckroat crosses through the center circle right in the middle of the floor. Bounce pass right wing, and we're going to have an illegal screen. Or no, it's going to be an offensive foul, I guess. I'm not sure what happened down low, but it's going to be whistled against Dahlquist.
It's going to be his third, team's first of the half.
He and Ribble working hard to get position, and I think
yeah. Two pretty athletic post players giving each other fits.
Eckroat around the defense to Sumner. Feeds down low. Ball tipped away by Dahlquist ahead to Medina. Medina then leads ahead to Abbott. Abbott stops, rises up, shot short, gets his own rebound, shot on the way. Good, and a foul.
Abbott now has six. Looking at number seven if he can hit this free throw.
Padding the stats.
The old Moses Malone.
Lynn back into the game, and coming out is Sumner. Jordan Reinholt will come. Must be coming in for Brett Abbott. 43-27. Abbott at the line for the Zebras for one. Eyes it, flies it, nope. 0-3 tonight?
Yeah, 0-3. He's got 6 points. That's one we'd like to take care of there.
Lynn down low to Huffman. Huffman out to Eckroat. Eckroat up the elbow to Stiver. Stiver on the left baseline. Jump pass outside to Lynn. Lynn just inside the three-point line. Jumper short. Holland to the rebound. Holly runs for Rochester. Pushes ahead to Abbott left wing. Abbott drives the baseline. Pull up. Tim Footer is short. And the rebound fought for. Abbott comes out of there with it. His jumper on the way, no good. Dahlquist's putback is no good. Gets the rebound and putback is good off the front of the rim. Rochester by 18.
Stays with it, gets his 6 point
yep.
of the night.
25, make that 45-27 Rochester. 5 to play in the third. Lynn around the defense and the paint. Leaner on the way is good. Trevor Lynn gets two to go in the lane. And now it's 45-29. Dahlquist. Jump passes off the back of Eckroat out of bounds, and it'll stay with Rochester out of bounds. It was Lee and Reinholt back in, Abbott and Thomas to come out, Yoder back in for North Miami, and Ribble to come out. 4:46 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 45-29. Medina will look to trigger it in, baseline left. No look pass to Holland, three left wing, off the mark, no good, and the weak side rebound to Dahlquist. Dom on the baseline to Reinholt. Jordan gives him the wing to Lee. And now to Medina. Medina, finger roll, no good. Rebound fall for it. Medina gets it back. His leaner off the lid is good. 47-29. Stiver runs around the defense in the lane. Runs over Medina. We're going to have a foul on Stiver. That'll be his second charge of the night. Rochester going to get it back. North Miami will call another timeout. It will be a 60. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. To play in the third quarter. Rochester up by 18 at 47-29. And I would take by the tone of Coach Boulder in the huddle there, he is not pleased. He's seen this for four games in a row. His team just basically fold up camp in the second half.
It's that, as a coach, it's that line in the sand. When is enough? The trend is falling apart in the second half, and he's just trying to light a fire any way he can, and if they respond the way he got into it,
they force a turnover, and it ends up for 2 points for Yoder. Holland up the floor against Eckroat. To Medina, high on the left side. Taylor, jump stop in the lane, and before the jump stop, He is fouled, and it'll be out of bounds to the Zebras with 4:07 to play in the third quarter. Varsity girls basketball tomorrow morning in North Miami. JV starts at 11 o'clock. Varsity around 12:30. You can hear that game on WROI. Brad Thomas and I will be there for that.
Brunch?
Absolutely. Holland for three. Left wing is good. In rhythm.
18. Yeah, that's the best important thing. A good pass sets up a great shot. You can catch in rhythm.
Jordan Reinhold fouls Sumner on the shot about 18 feet away from the basket, and that's going to send Sumner to the line for two.
Yeah, you don't need to jump to block that shot. Just contest it. It's an off-balance floater from 18 feet. You got the bad shot that you wanted, but you can't bail the kid out with a foul. I think Coach Reinholt will probably relay to Jordan personally as Foster checks in.
I can imagine. Left-handed free throw by Sumner's in and out, off the glass and back in. He'll have one more as Foster comes back into the game and Jordan will come out. One more coming for Sumner.
So fun to coach your kid.
Slides it, slides it, good. So 50-33. Ekro just as fouls Holland on the reach-in. Lanier will come back in for Rochester, as will Thomas. Okay. 3:50 to play, third quarter. Rochester at 50-33. And Rochester will have it right at the timeline, right in front of the scores tables. Medina will look triggered in.
Coach Reinholt's kind of settled in this kind of pattern of two guys in at a time and keeping guys fresh. And, you know, Holly stayed on the floor a lot of time. Medina, those guys have got it going. But, you know, really those other three guys are rotating in about two at a time.
Holland. Foster, three, right side is short. The putback by Medina is good. Rochester back by 19.
Medina now has 14.
Ekrode out to Sumner, three over Foster, good again. Now Rochester quickly inbounds. Medina pushes for Rochester, 52-36 Zebras. Medina around the defense, bounce pass to Foster, outside to Holland, three on the way, right wing, good, a foul.
That's a call that I've been looking for in our game. I mean,
that one was a no-brainer.
That was a no-brainer, but you've got to let the shooters land. That's just a dangerous play. Luckily, Alex didn't get hurt.
That's what I was just going to say.
You land, you come down on an ankle, God forbid a knee. Alex, he's got five threes on the night, three in this quarter.
And he buries a free throw, and now the lead is 20 for Rochester. Biggest lead of the night with 3:20 to play in the third quarter. As Medina tries to save the ball from going out of bounds, running over a Rochester cheerleader, cannot, and he'll stay with North Miami the far side as Brett Abbott comes in and Medina comes out.
All of a sudden, Alex got 22.
All of a sudden, yeah.
Well, I mean.
Yeah. 12. Not very long ago, he had, what, 13
or 15? He had 10 at half. He had 10 at half, and they've got 12 this quarter, and there's still 3 minutes left.
56-36 Rochester. Pass comes in over the defense.
Oh
my goodness. Holland is going to be... Holland is going to be called for the push-off foul.
Loose ball, you usually think like that, a wild pass. You give both players the opportunity to go after it.
Diver will come back into the game.
And the ball hit off the North Miami player's head. It looks like there was contact both ways. That's one of those in the NFL, contact on pass interference. If it's both guys, you kind of let it go.
Lynn.
There's a clear advantage.
Yeah, that was tough. I didn't see any arms extended either. And then Lynn loses the basketball right into the hands of Holland. He spots up for three. Right side is short. Rebound, fall four. Thomas comes out of there with it. Rochester the ball. Dom drives the baseline against Huffman, and he's going to be called for a block.
That last shot by Alec, I think you would call a heat check. It's hit a couple in a row. That's an awful quick quick shot. And
but if that thing goes,
yeah. I mean, it's... I mean, he's gotten hot. He got a 22, as I said, for Holland. Medina has 14.
Thomas to Leininger. Leininger, one dribble in the lane to Foster. Foster in the paint, rises up from 10 feet off the glass and good.
Foster has four.
58-36, Diver around the defense. In the corner to Lynn, three for North Miami. Nope, Thomas grabs the board, gives to Abbott. Brett runs down the left side of the floor. Now accelerates at the free throw line. Kicks it outside to Wilson Lee. Right side to Foster. Foster top to Abbott. Abbott directs traffic. Now to Dom Thomas. Ah, chuck that big man. Thomas drives. pull-up 10-footer, foul of the shot. Shot good and a foul.
He'll still get three-point play. He doesn't have to shoot three. He'll get it the old-fashioned way. He's going to earn it.
Dom in the scoring column for the first time tonight. 7 Zebras have scored. Always a good sign.
Dom's free throw, no good.
Yep. Well, something's going to happen on those drives. It's going to be a block or charge. Like you said, all night long, Stiver has decided he's going to the bucket, and you're either going to step in front or he's going to keep going.
That time he drew a foul.
Yep.
Lynn looks a bounce pass in. Over the top of the defense to Sumner. Sumner over to Reinhold. It's blocked. Reinhold then tips it ahead, but Ribble comes down with it, and he loses it right in the hands of Reinhold. Jordan now gives to Leininger. Rochester runs up 60-36. Right side to Wilson Lee. Behind the arc to Leininger. Over the top to Reinhold, who has two big threes tonight for the Zebras. To Abbott, to Leininger. Right side to Foster. Foster in the corner to Reinhold. Drives the baseline against Stiver. His layup is good. Jordan Reinhold has 8 and is 62-36. 1:50 to play in the third.
Be great to get that third in doubles.
Stiver throws up a tough shot. Reinhold with a rebound. Jordan rips and runs. Pushes ahead to Leininger. Leininger drives. Kicks it out to Wilson Lee. His jump on the way is short. Gets his own rebound. Puts it back up over the defense. It is no good. Leininger, his putback. Nope. And a rebound by Foster, but he's going to come over the back of Ribble to do it.
Got to like the tenacity of the Zebras on the boards both ends. You know, not too many offensive rebounds for North Miami and a whole bunch of offensive rebounds for Rochester tonight.
90 seconds of play, third quarter, 62-36. Rochester on top. Stiver pushes to Lynn. Lynn holds to Ribble just inside the three-point line, top of the key. One dribble inside the arc. Now outside to Lynn, high on the right side, dribble to the floor now for North Miami. Left side to Stiver. Stiver hesitates, drives in the paint, out to Lynn, wide open three, right side, no good, short, and the rebound to Wilson Lee, who gives to Abbott, a minute 10 to play in the third. And I think Coach Reinhold, Tony, wants one shot.
Maybe.
Tough task with a minute 10 to play, and boy,
yeah,
Abbott just got away with the carry.
And you don't have Alec Collins, so you don't really have a true point guard to run the offense.
Foster holds with 52. Top of the key to Reinhold. Now to Abbott. High on the left side is 48. To Wilson Lee. Bounce pass to Reinhold with 46. Reinhold to baseline to Abbott. Abbott wrap around pass to Wilson Lee. Kicks it out to Leininger. Leininger now to Foster. Behind the arc. Now to Reinhold. Jordan holds. Passes to Abbott with 35. In the corner to Foster with 32. One dribble to Reinhold with 29. Now to Leininger. Leininger around the defense. His leaner on the way is good by the freshman. That's an athletic shot right there. And it's 64-36 and 19. Lynn drives over the defense. No good. Reinhold with the rebound. Gives to Abbott with 13. Brett Abbott drives around the defense. Goes in for the layup. It's good with 10. Rochester by 30 with 8. Stiver with 6. Stiver pushes in the paint with 4. His jumper on the way is good. And Rochester will not get a shot off of the buzzer. After 3, Rochester up 66-38. You're listening to Zebra Basketball 92.1 WROI.
Are you tired of your internet speed slowing you down? Not a problem. Get connected at the speed of light over RTC's advanced fiber optic network. Work, surf, or play on the net faster than ever before. Choose from multiple residential or business packages with speeds so fast, it'll have you flying away. Already have RTC's Fiber Connect internet? Upgrade your package today. RTC. Local services, local support, and local investments.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
Shepherd's made my buying process easy. The sales staff at Shepherd's was extremely knowledgeable and helped me find the right vehicle at a price that fit my budget. They had a great selection of new and pre-owned vehicles to choose from, and they gave me a great deal on my trade-in. I wouldn't shop anywhere but Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester. They really are my local hometown dealer.
Going to the fourth and final quarter, the Rochester Zebras lead 66-38. And it'll be Rochester basketball to start the period, going to our right as Wilson Lee will look to trigger it in. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman.
Two good signs. Zebras offensive explosion of 32 points in the third quarter.
Unbelievable.
Good balance scoring. 8 of the 9 have scored, and don't have official rebounding statistics, but North Miami's absolutely one and done on their end.
Yeah.
Zebras have done a great job on the defensive boards tonight.
Well, I know that's one of the things that Coach Reinholt stressed in the last 2 weeks of practice. No more 3, 4, and 5 opportunities offensively.
Yeah, the Zebras have had several of those on their offensive end, and really, especially in that quarter, North Miami got one shot and they were done.
Sumner's three over Reinholtz, no good. Good block out by Medina, grabs the board, and now pushes up the floor to Wilson Lee. Wilson, left-handed layup, no good. Leininger with the rebound, and he loses it out of bounds. It'll go back to Rochester. Wilson Lee, the only one not in the scoring.
Yep, the only one. He's got, he missed 3 or 4 shots. He's gotten some looks, and he got a quarter to go, but, 8 of the 9 Zebras have scored.
66-38, Rochester up with 30 seconds gone in the final quarter. Stiver at the free throw line. Pull-up jumper is good. Rochester against the full court press breaks it easily to Wilson Lee. Bounce pass to Medina. Left side to Holland. Makes that to Leininger. In the corner to Foster. Reinhold holds. Top of the key to Medina. Fans of the volleyball line between the rings. Swings right side to Liam Leininger. Wilson Lee outside to Medina. Jumper off the glasses. Oh, in and out. No, that thing was down, Tony, and came out.
You get a point for that.
You should. Stiver, coast to coast. Layup is good. Rochester now looking for that offensive charge. Could get it that time.
Stiver's got 13.
66-42. Rochester up with 6:43 to play in the game. Leininger against the man-to-man defense. The Reinhold bounce pass to Medina. Taylor, wraparound pass to Wilson Lee. His shot is no good. And North Miami Stevens going out of bounds to Medina. Medina, leaner off the glass is good. Wilson Lee just can't buy a bucket tonight, poor kid.
Medina's got 16. You're right. That's as good a look as you're going to get.
Diver to Sumner for three. It's good off the rafters. It's 68-45. 6:10 to play in the third. I'll make
Sumner's
that in the fourth quarter.
Got 15, so two and doubles for North Miami. Those are the only two that are scoring.
Leininger travels. Holland and Dahlquist back in for Rochester. Eckroth and Huffman back in for the Warriors. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. 6 minutes to play in the game. Rochester leads 68-45. It'll be North Miami basketball going to our left. Diver to Lynn, quickly to Eckroth. Everything behind the three-point line right now. He works to the right wing. Feeds down low to Huffman, who loses the basketball. Still loose. Leininger picks it up. Liam off to Foster. Foster runs to our right. Bounce pass on the baseline to Dahlquist. Over the top of the defense of Leininger. To Medina. To Holland in the right corner. Down low to Dahlquist. He loses the handle. The Mavs scramble for it. Ball loose. Picked up by Huffman. Gives to Stiver. North Miami runs to our left. Stiver picks his way through the defense. Throws the shot up. Blocked out of bounds by Foster. Get it out of here!
That's where it helps. Foster being left-handed. That was his inside hand, but it's his dominant hand, so it was a nice, easy block for him. A right-handed player would have to come across the top or not be able to get as much on Foster that he could.
So Lynn will look to trigger it in. Lynn slaps the basketball, sends things in motion for the Warriors. Lynn gets it into Eckroth, loses it, now to Huffman. Huffman, low in the lane, throws up a shot, no good. Ball tipped out, now Lynn has it on the offensive rebound. His putback, no good, partially blocked by Dahlquist. Foster has it now, he loses it. Ball loose, good job by Dahlquist. Dahlquist dove for the ball, so did Lynn. Lynn came down to the back of the head of Noah Dahlquist. He'll go to the line to shoot one of the bonus. I think we already had one tooth lost tonight, haven't we?
I don't know. Ross Pearson took an awful spill in the JV game and come up, buddy. I don't know if the tooth stayed in or not, but I know there was a lot of blood up on the top of his mouth.
I need to check that out.
Yeah.
Free throw by Dahlquist is good.
Dahlquist now has 7 points. Zebras haven't got to the line a whole bunch tonight. They've only attempted, that's only their 7th free throw attempt of the night.
He didn't lose the tooth. Just didn't. Bloodied a little bit.
Okay.
Lynn, outlet pass. Layup is good.
Lynn's got 5.
69-47. Holland around the defense. In the corner to Foster. Down low to Dahlquist. Dahlquist back to Duane against Ribble. Out to Holling. Quickly sinks it to Medina. Now to Abbott. Abbott to Dahlquist. Down low to Foster on the block. Kicks it out to Abbott. Fakes a three. Drives it. And he travels.
He had Holland open in the corner on that baseline drive. It's great to go to that opposite corner. A lot of times it's open. He was underneath the basket. I think he has an easy kick to Holland for another three if he makes that pass.
Divers pass is tipped away. Eckert picks it up and travels. 4:42 to play in the game. Rochester up 69-47. Thomas back into the game. Dahlquist comes out.
Yeah, just really good substitution pattern by coach. Of course, it's easier when you're up by a decent margin to get those rotations you want. But these guys, no matter what lineup he's put on the floor, they've worked pretty well together.
Padina gets the inbounds pass, gives him the corner to Thomas. Thomas behind the three-point line. North Miami to man-to-man defense. Medina holds above his head, fakes the pass, gives to Thomas on the right baseline. He gets a double team. Dom, one dribble, kicks it out to Abbott. Holland fakes the three, drives it to the free throw line. To Thomas, back to Holland, quickly to Abbott. Abbott drives in the paint, rises up in the lane. No good. Huffman to the rebound. Oh! Huffman then threw a punch and smacks Abbott right in the mouth. I don't think it was a punch so much as get off my arm.
Referee's going to talk. How are you going to call this one?
Huffman, guys, apologize.
Going to call player control.
So it will not be a free throw shooting violation, but it will be a turnover on North Miami. And Coach Bowles are not happy with the call. He's getting talked to. It won't be very long till his cup runneth over.
No.
Thomas in the corner to Foster. Back to Thomas against Huffman. To a cutting Medina. Layup is good.
Nice pass by Dom. Good cut by Medina. Way to work together, boys.
71-47, four to play in the game. Lynn high on the right side. One dribble, a couple of dribbles. Now middle of the floor at the elbow. Kicks it out to Eckroth. Eckroth inside the three-point line. Now backs out behind the three-point line. Down low to Lil Huffman. Tough pass to handle. Goes out of bounds. And Jordan Reinhold comes back into the game. Who's coming out? Foster will be the one coming out. Sumner back in for the Warriors. 71-47 Rochester. 3:45 to play in the game. Post-game show coming up after this. I'm kind of anxious to hear what Coach Reinhold has to say about this performance tonight. Reinhold for three, right wing. Nope, short. Diver the rebound. Diver runs to Ribble. Ribble shot, no good. A foul coming on Rochester. You know, he's got that. Jordan Reinhold just shot a three. Looked good. He didn't follow a shot. If he did, he gets a rebound. And he gets that coach's head tilt. You've done it. I've done it. Coach Reinhold does it. Like, really? Just go get the ball.
Right. You know, there's certain things you'd like to think coaches' kids kind of know. There's some one of those things that anybody, I mean, especially those ones that come right back to you. You know, doesn't take much come right back to you. And you can get another attempt or keep possession for your team, but sometimes looks just says enough.
And we're going to have a lane violation against North Miami, so the Ribble free throw is missed anyway. Will be waved off. 3.5 to play in the game. Rochester up 71-47. Medina, the Leininger.
Zebras have a longer layoff again. 28th, when they play next. Lewis Cass.
Yes.
That's Tuesday.
That is the 30th.
30th, yes, right, 30th. So, you know, another little break here. So you want to keep working on your thing, stay a little sharp. And
you like
maybe
that?
These last 3 minutes. You're talking to a guy who's got how many games in 11, 12 tomorrow?
Well,
I mean, I don't like those long breaks. One might be okay, but.
You know, I was, oh, my good heavens.
They're going to get awfully busy, in, obviously, in January then. They're going to have to catch up on that. You know, they've had these long layoffs.
Yeah.
They're gonna get busy at some point.
You know, I was kind of worried about the rust, and I don't think there was any.
No.
3 minutes playing the game. Rochester up 71-47. Sumner, leaner over Reinhold. No good. Jordan with the board.
I think the opponent helps in terms of struggling with their confidence a little bit, but still, the Rochester Zebras did a lot of good things. They forced Miami to play, North Miami to play a certain style. They did the things that we need to do offensively and defensively.
And as big a lead as Rochester is having or has right now, the passing has still been crisp for the most part. That one just about tipped away, but Leininger has it. He goes in against Huffman, no good. Rebound, Stiver, and Stiver's run. Stiver, and Thomas fouls him on the shot. And that's going to send Jacob Stiver to the line to shoot two. But they've moved the ball very well tonight.
Yeah, they've gotten a little more four out, one in kind of offense where they're moving the ball, flashing the post, getting the post, some post feeds, and then they're kicking out. Obviously, they've scored 71. This is kind of a no-brainer, but obviously the best offensive performance they've had overall. But
because
their ball movement's better.
Yeah. They go from 32 in the third quarter to, what, five in this quarter?
Yeah. And some of that's just kind of the raggedness of the play at this point. It's kind of, you know, a helter-skelterish, and I think guys are tired because of the pace of this game.
Sure, absolutely. Second one by Stiver is good again. 71-49, Rochester on top. North Miami to man-to-man defense, press, and they force a turnover. The rebound and putback by Sumner is no good. Foster with the rebound, and he runs it up the floor. 2:10 to play. In the fourth quarter, Thomas, leaner off the glass is good. Nice move by the big postman, and Rochester will take a timeout. It's a 60. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. To play in the game. Rochester up 73-49. After the Rochester timeout, it'll be North Miami basketball underneath the Rochester basket going to our left.
Some scores to update. Boys action. Northfield 42, Wabash 39 into the third quarter. Southwood 30, Manchester 29 also into the third quarter at half. Valley Boys 42, Wichita 18.
Christmas bought. Wait.
What?
Christmas started?
No.
Shocker.
Why would he do that?
Yeah, I know.
Still games left to play.
Stiver for three. Nope. And we're going to have an offensive rebound, actually a push on the Sumner, and that's going to send Jordan Reinhold to the line to shoot, where are we at, two?
Should be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Minute 54 to play in the game. Rochester going to go to 2-2 overall and 1-0 in the TRC. North Miami going to fall to 0-5 overall and 0-1. And the Three Rivers Conference. Lady Zebras looking to stay perfect tomorrow as they travel to North Miami tomorrow morning at 11 o'clock. JV game tips at 11, varsity around 12:30.
Probably plenty of seats available. You're thinking about
good
it's
heaven.
Usually not a well-attended game.
Good heaven.
So if you don't have much to do, you can probably find plenty of good seats.
Jordan makes 1-2 on that trip. Ribble comes back in. Yeah, there'll be plenty of good ones to be had tomorrow morning. You're right. 74-49. Minute 54 to play in the game. Stiver pushes for North Miami.
You want to hear
Sumner
kind of
for three? Nope.
The one negative stat for the Zebras.
Sure.
4 of 12 from the free throw line.
Yeah, he's not going to like that, is he?
No.
100 seconds left in the game. Rochester up 74-49. Dahlquist, one dribble to Lee. Go to the basket, young man. Shoot the ball. Over the top of the defense to Foster. Foster to Reinhold, high on the left side of the minute 30 to play. Reinhold's layup is good. Nice job by Dahlquist.
And with that, Jordan Reinhold becomes the third Zebra in double figures.
And Reinhold just commits a foul, and that's going to send Stiver to the line to shoot two.
With 11, so you got Alec Holland with 22. You got Taylor Medina with 18, Abbott with 8, Noah Dahlquist with 7, now Jordan Reinhold with 11. So that's good. We talked about finding other scores, and
yeah,
you know, Medina,
yeah.
Good night. Jordan, good night. That's
checking in with the Warriors.
that's a good sign. Hopefully a build on this is of things to come. Got a good cast team coming in here on the 30th.
Yeah.
Not quite the same team yet last year, but still a really good team nonetheless. That'll be a team that'll probably challenge your athleticism and pressure you a little bit. And, you know, some of these, you know, they're going to have to play obviously a little bit more sharp than they did tonight. But that'll be good. You got time to prepare for that one and get ready to go. Plus it's here.
Yeah,
it is here.
Yep.
76-51, Rochester on top. Reinholdt. Right side to Foster. Foster in the paint. Outside to Jordan. Behind the three-point line to Dahlquist. Dahlquist looking for Leininger. Has him on the high on the left side under a minute to play in the game. To Foster. Foster one dribble between the ring. Outside to Wilson Lee. Wilson Lee against works against Shane Holden. Wilson Lee. Outside to Dahlquist with 45. To Leininger with 40. Leininger against Zane Briggs, who's in the basketball game for the first time tonight. To Foster. Looks back door to Reinholdt, can't get him, and then throws it out of bounds. Wilson Lee was going to grab it, thought it was for someone else. Pulls his hand back, and it goes out of bounds. 34 to play in the game, 76-51 Rochester. North Miami pushes, left side to Holden. Top to Attaway. Quickly to Reinholdt, down low to Attaway against Wilson Lee. His shot no good, but a foul coming on Wilson Lee. Man, Attaway is a big kid. 6'4 senior, Shondell Attaway for North Miami.
Yeah, that's some raw skill, athleticism, maybe something you can find going down the road. I mean, rebounding has been a problem for North Miami tonight. Zebras did a good job crashing the boards, but North Miami hasn't gotten offensive rebounds, and they've given up a lot of Rochester offensive rebounds with Hathaway makes his first free throw. So maybe something Coach Bolzer looks to moving forward.
One more for Attaway. Second one is no good this time, and the rebound fought for. North Miami comes out of there with it. Holding out to Eckroad with 15. Eckroad drives in the corner to Yoder. He'll fire a three. It's off the mark, no good. Holding with the, make that Reinholdt with the rebound with 10. Jordan runs, pulls it out, and Rochester doesn't have to score again, or shoot again, I guess you should say. 4-3-2-1, and that'll do it. Rochester wins tonight 76-52. Post-game show coming up next on 92.1 WROI.
First Federal Savings Bank is Rochester's only locally owned bank. Stop in today to start a new checking or savings account. Learn more about our online banking options or sign up for Go Green Checking, the checking account that pays you back every time you use your card. Stop in today to see why local banking is better banking. First Federal Savings Bank, serving Rochester and surrounding communities since 1966. At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
I've been buying vehicles at Shepherd Chevrolet for over 16 years. They've always had the vehicle I wanted at a price that I could afford. I trust Shepherd's sales staff to give me the best price and the best financing available. From my work trucks to my personal vehicle, Shepherd's is the only choice for me. Stop out to Shepherd Chevrolet today to get your next vehicle. They really are my local hometown Chevy dealer.